one win, just one. Oh God, that would change everything. Just one.
Please state your name and your reason for being here.
My name is Noel Kunz. I'm a professional yo-yoer, and I'm here because I want to perform for International Secret Agents. And I kind of have to because it's part of my master plan. See, things to do before I die. Performing at ISA is right in between buying a flying squirrel and drinking tea with Philip Wang. I just have to do it. So, is this the audition part? Do I get to yo-yo and show my skills? Alright, let's go.
For one time, say, you know, I'd won talent shows so many times and I worked hard for those and those goals have been reached, but to be a yo-yo champion just one time and in a very difficult state, That would mean a lot. That would mean everything.
There were so many tricks that were completely, you know, mind-boggling that I wanted to do that. I wanted to be that good. I wanted to make people go, what are you doing? You know, I wanted to confuse people. I wanted to be that one guy that was so entertaining that you want to know what he's doing before you can say, I want to do that.
My fiance and I used to have arguments, you know, saying, I kind of, you know, for a long time I just wanted one kid because I was scared of, you know, not treating them equally, or maybe one kid wins something and the next one doesn't, and, you know, I wouldn't know how to feel because I went through that. I think that's why I need this so bad, you know? When I was younger, I was in drumline in high school, and the year before I joined, they won the world championships, and I went in. My freshman year, we got second. We dropped down to sixth sophomore year, junior year, came back to fourth. My senior year, we just had the show of our lives, and it was good enough for third. And while I was crying in happiness, it just, later on, I knew it wasn't enough. When marching band season came, placing the highest in the biggest division, fourth place. Now, we had won the class national championship my freshman year in the smaller class that we were in, but not the grand national championship. And then my brother came, you know, a couple years later, wins three national championships in a row. But while I'm so happy for him, it just kills me, because then in his winter guard, he wins a world championship, and I mean, I'm so happy for him. I'm happy for him, but I just feel left out for myself. And then, you know, my senior year, I go into the solo contest, and I get second, which once again was something coming from behind. People don't really give me credit for that, and that's fine. But it just hurts.
You've never had one performance where you thought,
I could say that with, you know, the world championships, the last one I did in 2013. But that wasn't even the point. I would have exhibitioned that if I could have. You know, I proposed to my fiance, and oh, that was just the greatest show of my life. Everything went down perfectly. But I think the guys who won actually did deserve to win. I was told that I actually could have gone first by the guy running the contest. Right after the show, he told me, you know, you could have medaled it, you could have won, but you weren't yo-yoing when you proposed, and that cut into the time that you had, so just shaved off any chance of me winning. It's hard for me to think that I got gypped so much, because in the end, I won. I won that show, you know? I got a girl who I thought was completely out of my league, was too smart for me, wouldn't want me for who I am. I got her to fall in love with me, and it's just hard to get an angle of I feel gypped out of that show, and I got everything I could have dreamed of and more. You know, after that show, Dazzling Dave had me sign his book, and he only has seasoned veterans, somebody who's actually done stuff in yo-yoing, sign that book, and I cried when I signed it. I cried because I didn't think I would ever be that good enough for anything in yo-yoing to become legendary in any sort of anything, in any aspect, and I did it that night. We still got gold medals. And I'd like to thank Jack Finn, the guy who was running the division that day and couldn't be there. I'd like to think he had something to do with that and giving us these commemorative gold medals so that we could have something to remember that night by, and I'm never gonna forget that night. So yeah, you could say, you know, I screwed myself out of winning, sure, but it was the closest I could have gone to winning, and that just didn't even matter anymore. Like I said, I would have exhibitioned that show if I could have, just as long as I did it. If I'm gonna be brutally honest, I think we should have got third because we were cleaner than the guys who got third. But I'm not gonna say we should have won that. And there has not been one contest where I felt I should have won because I'm not that naturally talented. I'm not, I haven't been doing these technical contests for too long or too seriously even. It's always been a performance thing. And I won that with collaboration, winning it twice. You know, that's a performance thing. Giving people something they've never seen before, something that I get high off of. I love that. But there hasn't yet been a yo-yo contest, a strictly yo-yo contest that I've even felt like I got gypped out of anything. No, I just felt like I haven't earned it yet. And that's what makes me sad because I've been here longer than so many of these guys and I'm not that good yet. But then it becomes a question, am I that good or is it just that maybe I didn't have the kind of training, maybe I wasn't looking to train in the right areas. And that's what this newest job at Duncan's done for me. You know, getting to train 10 hours a day, 4 days a week, and just get cleaner and better. I think now is a time where I have to really show everything I've got because, you know, my relationship's kind of on the line for this. I've had to hold off our marriage for a year for something that I need to do for myself. And I can't go on saying that I didn't live my dream. I'm not gonna be a father and, you know, and granted, you know, we're not having any kids yet, we're not planning to, but I can't, in good conscience, have a kid and tell them to do what they want to do when I didn't even get close. I have to be that, because I'm sick of going generations of not doing that. My dad chose a great path, chose a great career, but I know it wasn't what he wanted to do at first, you know, and I know he wanted to be a musician, and in a lot of ways he lived that through me, but I don't want to be a musician anymore. I like doing it. But now when it's forced, and that's why I started yo-yoing, to get away from that. And I need to be that role model if I'm gonna move on to the regular life that I know everybody wants me to just kind of go on to. I've been in this too long. Why haven't you moved on? I just have to. I have to.
Did placing in the top 10 internationally at the International Yo-Yo Contest change anything about like your game or your mentality going forward?
Placing, going from last seed, going into finals and placing top 10, getting 9th in 5A, it changed everything for me because I felt like I finally found a good division for myself that wasn't artistic performance, which you would see maybe once a year. So yeah, to be able to do 5A was just amazing, and to see that I can do that well and I wasn't even on the top of my game, I mean, knowing I had more potential, it changed everything because now I found an actual technical division that I can actually do something with. And it just brought a new life, something like 11 years down the road, 10, 11 years down the road, it brought new life to my yo-yoing. You know, where most people are peaking at about 4 years, I'm actually just now starting to do well 11 years into it.
Can you marry me?
She's like, I want to be in your lap.
Let me see. Oh, that's okay.
Oh, I never really wanted to perform. I'm really shy and I have stage fright. So I think it was like the night before I was so tired and just like I had a talk with Noel the night before the World Yo-Yo performance. I was like, I don't want to do this anymore.
Yeah, and I couldn't say a thing because in my mind I'm like, just one more. I promise it'll be worth it. Yeah. And I won't ask you again.
And before, like when I was in high school, I did like, you know, theater and all that, and I was fine. It just, I don't know, grew out of me, and it's weird performing for an audience that they, you know, they critique you and yo-yoing in that area, and then I don't even dance. I'm not a dancer at all, so I don't know how I did it, but it was. It's stressful because you're in a room full of like these eyes like lurking at you and like, okay, what is this girl doing? So it's, I don't know. I like it now. I mean, I still support him, just not on stage.
Yeah. You have to remember too, if it weren't for yo-yoing, I wouldn't have met Denise. If it weren't for those videos, if it weren't for me just yo-yoing in general, you know, because then there wouldn't be the videos, I wouldn't be performing. We wouldn't have had our first date. So it all revolves around that, and that was kind of the idea behind that proposal, was bring us back to where it all started, and then some. But I don't know, it's been quite a challenge, because that was one of the things that I think, you know, she definitely knew I wanted to do. I'm not sure if you knew I wanted to keep going with it as far as I am, but it's always going to be a part of me, whether it's, you know, what I do for a living or even just a hobby, it's going to be a part of this. But I think that's where that challenge comes in. It's not like, like for example, I got my degree in advertising. It's not like I'm, you know, working in that industry and only that industry and it's consuming my life. This is the industry I chose. So without there being a good footprint of what to do, you know, as a yo-yoer, because there's only a handful of us in the world who do this, especially in the modern era, it leaves a lot of uncertainty. So that's where it seems like everything we're doing is a risk, you know, and losing that reassurance of money and, you know, stability, it scares us. So I have to work better at making sure that she's comfortable and that she's okay, because this is something that I need to learn in order to build my own character. If I, you know, if I can't take care of her through this while I'm trying to achieve what I have to do, you know, when it's her turn, she wants to do something great, you know, I have to be there, and I have to learn how to deal with this through what I'm experiencing now so I can make it better for her too.
I mean, it's hard. It's not easy. You just have to think like, okay, what if you do give up now? What if you quit? What next? You know, he's always been there, and you know, where he's my life. I can't imagine anything that, you know, if anything would happen, and what am I going to do tomorrow? You know, why did I give that up after all these years? We're going on 5 years. Mm-hmm. And I know we want to be with each other, and I want to be with him. I want to spend the rest of my life with him, and it's, you do have to make sacrifices to get there, and this is just one of those obstacles that we have to get through. It's just, think of it like hurdling.
Yeah, it's, and she made a good point too, was every time I wanted to give up, just move back here, just have a quote-unquote normal life, so that we could, you know, spend every day together. You know, I was willing to do that. And there comes times where it's really hard, and I want to just drop it. But then she says that, what if you quit now? And you did all this for nothing. Mm-hmm. You know, you built all this, and then you didn't achieve your goal. And I feel like only after I reach this, I can move on to the next goal. Not give up on life, but just find another goal to reach. But I have to complete this. It's consumed almost 12 years of my life, and I need to do this for me, you know? I need to do this so that we can bring this on to our future kids and just, you know, have that sense of accomplishment that
took both of us to do.
So, Denise, you would be okay if this yo-yoing thing went on for the next 10 years?
It's what he likes. It's what he wants to do. And it, like I said, it did bring us together, and it's not something that I would take away from him. You know, what if I had a hobby or something that I'm really passionate about and he gives me an ultimatum, say, okay, be with me or drop this. You know, that's not love. That's not right. You know, I would never ask him to give up something that makes him who he is and was something that I fell in love with him for.
Even in 25 years when his kids are competing in yo-yoing.
It's then I'd be there. It's probably gonna happen.
I'd be a yo-yo mom.
Yep. Today we're at Lucky's. He's got the world's largest collection of yo-yos. Turned a whole section of his house into a museum. And yeah, we're having a yo-yo meet, and should be cool. There's gonna be some historic stuff there that I'd like to one day be a part of. We'll go check that out. With the rubber rims. It's one of the first yo-yos I had, but not with the rubber rims. I had the two. I don't have the rubber rings. That's the one. And it was revolutionary. Yes, it was revolutionary because it was the first yo-yo. It was by Yo-Yo Gem. It was the first yo-yo to actually think about rim weight distribution.
Yeah.
And it was 50% rim weight, which was huge at the time. And then the next spin factor, super spin factor, went to like 70%. Now, I'm sure you don't even calculate yours.
Yeah.
It just is now, but that was the yo-yo that made all yo-yos get that spin time in terms of stability, not in terms of just getting a spin time. Frank Sinatra had one just like this from this series. And I think after he passed away, it sold an auction for like 10 grand because it was his. First off, I wouldn't play a Tiffany silver yo-yo, but it is cool. The artistry's there, so anyone who's like complaining that our yo-yos are $60 to $120, well, look at this. This was done way back in the day, and no one complained then. They just simply didn't buy them. This is the Fire yo-yo. They sold this on Infinite Illusions. It has a special string and everything, but you can actually set this on fire. It'd go, and you can return it and redo it so long as you got new... something to light, a new wick, but yeah, it's an actual finished couple here. Those sold for a couple $100, and that was crazy at the time. They play, but the historic value of those, and you can tell he actually did burn this one up a little bit. That's awesome. I didn't think I'd ever actually see one. Honestly, never thought I would, but that's cool, and it's just here on the ground. It's here on the ground.
Now, would you light it on fire and play with it?
No, because it did come with a glove, but I think I'd still be too scared. Something, I'd be wanting to do more tricks than it could actually go for, and I wouldn't. It's not even the price thing, it's just me and fire. I don't think that would go too well. Wouldn't want to get burned.
I think the best players in the world, and most of them have passed through here, the thing that impresses me the most is the amount of time they're willing to practice. And with yo-yoing, it's largely about practice and practice and practice. And it's not about practicing the things you're good at. And I see a lot of guys make that mistake. They come in and they constantly throw the trick or two that they're really good at. And what they don't work on is what they're not as good at. And if Noel starts working on the things that he's just not quite as good at, That's where it's going to come out, being a champion. It's working on those things that you're not good at. I've been involved with yo-yos back when Nationals was strictly fixed axle, and now we've got all the non-responsive transaxles and ball bearings and who knows what to make those yo-yos spin forever. I will tell you, he's very quick, and I've watched him throw. He's a very fast thrower, very quick moves, very accurate. So that's what you have to be with the new yo-yos. Some players just have that natural quickness to them, that fast twitch muscle fiber, if you will, and he's got it. So I think it's just, like most things, it's just a matter of more practice. But he's there if he gets the practice in. He's got the certainly the skills almost, and he's certainly got the right muscle tissue to do it.
Terrible plastics, and I think I'm getting too used to them.
Okay. I'm aware of my surroundings.
mics on that. Place this one.
Okay.
I have a lot to work with this. That's
where you I got am. Me excited. In a yo-yo way.
You got a yo-yoer.
I got a yo-yoer.
So what I do is I get up and I just do a complete cold run just to kind of know that I can try and just be there and get ready. So.
See what I mean? Cold run. Let's try this again. Try to pace yourself right. Yeah. No warm up, no nothing. Just gotta pace myself better. The nerves will get to me later. Try this again.
When I ain't around you. Mitchie, Mitchie, too biggie to be expressing. I'm thinking I love the thought of you more than I love your presence. And the best thing now is probably for you to exit. I'll let you go, let you back. I finally learned my lesson. No half stepping. Either you want it or you just playing. I'm listening to you knowing I can't believe what you're saying. There's a million news, baby, this will go.
I read this article once. And I mean, I've heard these before. You know how you know you've met the right person? And, you know, you can do this together, you can do that, but nobody ever says that you need to know how to suffer together. And when she was stressed, she would find me crying in some corner for no reason at all. And she'd just kind of be there for me. Later on, I found out that I was diagnosed with severe depression. Could have been stemming from, you know, not wanting to do anything or with my degree or just not liking that industry, but we've also been through pay cuts and losing jobs. I'll lose my job 1 year, she'll lose hers. And we kind of pick each other back up now. We're still in debt, majorly in debt, but we're never missing payments. We budget well, we can suffer together. When you can suffer together, anything else can be endured. It just can. But it still hurts me that I'm still having to put this on hold. And winning would be something I can move on from and, you know, start thinking about what we can do together a little bit more. I know it's selfish. Yeah, anyone can say that. Why are you trying to do this for a childhood dream? And what I say to those people is, how many of your childhood dreams have you achieved? How many times have you had to suffer the way we have? How much did they pay you to not live your dream? It doesn't make any sense to me. That rationale doesn't make any sense. Failing at something you don't want to do just because there's money, I can't do it. It doesn't even make me happy when I get paychecks. You know that? Money doesn't make me happy. It doesn't. But unfortunately, that's how our world runs, and trying to mix that with a toy, a skill toy that there's not a big industry for, there's not much money for. That's rough. Having to build an industry for myself rather than, like, I feel like it actually would be easier going into music because there's already an outlet to make some sort of money. Even if it's not a lot, you can still be performing. I have to find that myself. I had an agent who just couldn't keep up with what I was doing because it was just so different, because he only managed other musicians, and he did great for what he could do, but nobody can really help me, or nobody really has. I've had a lot of broken promises even in this industry, and it takes a toll, but at the end of the day, you have to sacrifice way more than any of the books are ever going to tell you, way more than anything you're going to learn in school. You know, you have to get that true life education, that self-education. You can't... I'm so glad I went to college, you know? I'm so glad. It was the biggest financial mistake of my life. But I can't really say any, I have any regrets, because that's what got me to where I am. That's what got me yo-yoing. But there's no degree for yo-yoing. There's no degree for performing in the way I want to perform. So I had to sacrifice my whole degree, my whole college career, what it was for. And that's something I think my family has a hard time seeing, and my parents worry about, because they're parents. You know, my dad's actually really successful now, and it took him a while, but I'm just not there yet. And I know they're upset with that. But at the same time, they're there for me, and it's making other people sacrifice, so this is a lot of pressure. I need to win this to make assurance that I'm on the right path, that I'm doing something right in this world. I want to be remembered as somebody who kept fighting. No, I'm not an alpha male. I was never known to be the best leader, but I was known for always caring and always trying to do my best, even if it wasn't the best. Anyone else would have quit after so many silver medals and anything in life. I'm still going. Still going. Nothing's going to stop me from that.
Do you need more pads?
I'm saying that's why I sucked like crazy this morning. And that... it's the one thing that was caught on film. Because I've had some really good morning ones. I've had some worse ones than I had today, but that's why I should have stuck with the one I was practicing with, and I changed the pads yesterday, so they'll be broken in properly. Oh, no, man.
No, I remember how I did this.
He caught my anger on film. I threw my yo-yo on my bed. Of course, it's one of those memory foam matches, so it just stayed there. It didn't really bounce.
Put your finger on his chin. This? Yes. Can I get some gauze here?
Do you need some light? Or...
yeah, I need some gauze. Need a swab. Okay. Like, swab me some
on his chin.
Yes, one. Thank you.
So quiet now.
I ran out of hands. Okay, what do you need me to pull? Try to start the left ear. That's on this side. Yeah. Like the bottom of it. Just kind of push down the bottom just a little bit.
Okay, so you want me to go like...
yeah, that way I'm going to pull away. And then we can get... it's just kind of sticking to the blade too much. There you go. Yeah, okay. Now I can free him from... yeah. There you go. And it'll straighten. You're right, fella.
We're losing him.
You're right, Phil. You're gonna be okay. Look at the size of this drop there.
It varies. Like, some people like raw yo-yos where there's no finish on it, and like you're roughing up the surface of like the aluminum. And by blasting it, you're doing two things. One is you're preventing the yo-yo from oxidizing. If you have no anodizing on it, it just kind of like keeps it, you know, it's not shiny. It's got this nice kind of like flat surface. Also, a lot of yo-yoers like to have like smooth like finger grinds when they're doing anything with their skin contact. They don't want the yo-yo to have any resistance at all. So by roughing up the surface, you're giving it less surface space for contact on your hand.
hence longer spin times. That's pretty much what it is. A lot of people, it just, you know, like, it's just a single, like, solid blast, nothing interesting. So I've kind of taken up to the next level. I actually am kind of applying my artistic talent or creativity by doing masking, like technology or masking on the yo-yos to give it like some neat designs. So just wait and see what's coming out from Ten Yo-Yo. You'll be really thoroughly impressed.
It's pretty good. Even with my marks on there, my battle scores. Damn, I think I did a pretty good job. Now make sure you keep them away from water. Don't feed them after midnight. Mm-hmm. All right. Ta-da! Drop burr. This might be the first contest where I actually don't watch other people. Even though I'll have gone first, I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll have to see how happy I am with myself. The last contest, I kind of went in the middle, so I still watched everyone. It didn't psych me out. Ended up getting third at that one. We'll see how it goes. You know, I have to set the bar, but I know it's five people, but it's still a big deal, especially when they're all five of them are pretty good. You know, I have to stand out. I have to be clean. I have to keep a complete performance, and that'll lead me to the top.
Every day, I help Noel how to like perform properly, build his routine, so he has the edge of winning the competition. So, like every day, he shows me his tricks, and like I kind of tweak them every now and then. So, which will get more points? Which would like be a good trick for the competition? Which one should we remove from his routine? So, on what I saw, he has a chance to win Florida States because in Disney, we practice eight to 10 hours a day. So with that preparation for 3 months, I think he could win the contest really easy.
It's something I actually just found out earlier today, that he's never won a contest. And that's always, that actually really shocked me when I found that out, because he is such a performer, and that he's always just been so close to winning, but always just that one step behind someone else.
Coolest trick I know?
Oh, I love this.
Oh,
oh,
no!
Where did that come from?
Did you just put it in half?
How did you do
Wait,
that?
Wait, what?
It's on there. Whoa!
That's the coolest one.
Wait, what's on there?
That was so cool.
Yeah. Casual.
Low-key. Yeah.
Wow. Low-key. I'm really impressed.
Low-key counter.
Yeah, that was awesome.
I've played with the big ones that have like the
shoes. Okay.
But they're giant.
I'm yo-yo.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
I'm so
impressed.
So you guys work for me?
For Duncan, yeah.
So you get paid to do this, like, to yo-yo?
Yeah. I'm not volunteering here. Yeah, that's what we do for a living, so. It's what we do.
Get to make amount of money.
We get to, you know, travel and do whatnot.
Yo-yo?
Like, you travel for yo-yo?
Where do you see, it's a sport.
It's national. Everywhere.
I've never I'm heard serious. Of this.
It's
I'm
a
sorry.
Sport. I'm new to this.
Everywhere.
It's like when
Both
people say, what's field hockey?
New York, LA, things like that.
Right.
Yeah. It's like ice hockey, but it's like on grass.
You're going to Tokyo?
Yes.
It's like soccer.
Yeah, August.
Yo-yo, that's so cool. I didn't know this was
really easy.
You make it sound so easy.
I don't get how it makes it work. Like, I don't understand.
Here, you're going to help me do a trick so you kind of understand, right?
Ready, do it, Raga.
She needs space, though.
She needs to give her some space. Give her some space.
Right index finger out. And keep it very steady.
Watch her freak it.
I need
to She's so scared.
You do have a little bit of control, that's how you do it. So.
Like, let me try.
Strings going off,
but there's not.
Just one.
I used to yo-yo.
Just one.
Are you a yo-yo-er? Yes, one time my dad bought me a yo-yo. yo-yo and I went ham with it till it broke. And then I never yo-yoed again.
That's so cool, the bouncy thing with your arm.
I'm ready. Yeah, I went through a yo-yo.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. I went ham with my
yo-yo. Oh, whoa.
I went ham with my yo-yo. I think everybody had a yo-yo.
Mistakes. For example,
how long have you been yo-yoing?
12 years now.
Okay, well, that's 12 years now. That's like majority.
You have a tangle, but if you find just the right segment, it'll come out.
See, but what happens if you mess up and it gets all tangled? 12,
then you get a tangle. What happens?
You get a tangle.
Like, yeah.
I've ruined so many yo-yos.
So, like, 12 years, that's like radical. They're like, come on.
What? Never comes back.
Have you seen that? That's so cool. Bring the heat.
Learn something new every day.
Yo, yo,
just try. Thanks.
That's awesome.
Thanks for helping me out.
So we hope everybody is ready for today's contest. Be sure to check out our booth. We do have Tim Yo-Yo over there that is going to be selling product, as well as Yo-Yo Community. The booth will be set up momentarily. So if you guys are ready for a yo-yo contest, let's get all of our yo-yoers out here making some noise. Let everyone know where we're at. Yeah! Everybody stay tuned. We're going to be right back in just a few minutes to begin our contest.
You don't necessarily have to be like number one all the time, but like the energy and the strive to be there and want to be there is what I'm interested in. It just, that's why Noel is, he's like, he offers a lot more than just competing. He can give us a lot of input on yo-yos, even, you know, design-wise, fashion. He's got this like style about him that everybody, I mean, when he's got the stage presence. I think that's also where it, like, you know, if I'm hitting the nail on the head with that, it's just like he's there and everybody's like looking up, like if they were in a daze or tired or yawning or whatever. It's just like he's just like he brings it.
He's a great guy, all around great guy, great with people, great yo-yo player. I can't say enough great things about the guy. He's awesome. He's more of a performer than a competition player, and while it does great for the audience and the crowd that's watching him, sometimes that doesn't do well for the competition itself as far as placing. But he's a great performer. Even if he doesn't place high, it still entertains the crowd.
When I do my body, my body tangler, it actually does tangle if I don't get it right. But everything else, the string has to be really worn, and I don't know why. Never another threesome. My 1A has got to be fresh.
Ladies and gentlemen, put those hands together once again as we begin our aerial division for Noel Kunz. Continuing in our aerial division, next up we have Adam Reeder. I'll keep hiding.
The fact that you played through that is insanity.
I got that.
I got it back, but I think that's -1 each throw.
Oh, it's worth it. You only threw it like twice, the whole thing.
So let's see. I got through it.
No matter what, man, it was a sick performance.
You got Troy's shirt on? You know he's my best friend.
Yeah. First time I met him was at Florida States, I think. Or that, or Southeast Regionals.
when I can bring it as such. Let's pursue when there's crushing all the wounds with a touch. And sooner we unite in a crew of a trust.
There you go. Gotta bring it back.
Pursue
yep.
Love.
Yep.
Let's do what we gotta do and do it for in the crew and trust them.
One. That would change everything. Just one.
In third place, Adam Reeder. In second place in the Iron Division, Jared Pod. And your 2015 Florida Yo-Yo State Champion of the Aerial Division. Give it up for Noel Kunz.
I didn't want to come across as like in your face. That's the one thing I want to just before. I plan on seeing you. I plan on working with you more. I learned a lot from you. You know. Do you have any extra Takeshi dice you want to trade for a Jake dice? Can we get one? Or can we get that one? I just like for real. Like I wonder. That's it. You have something. You really do. Let me go. Let's go.
Move on to the next stream now.
Oh, I'm going to BAC.
Okay. Next stream is we both get good jobs so that I could feed into getting my own company.
Okay.
I was gonna tell you.
And then things work out, we can get married sooner. Does that sound good?
You think?
Yeah. Things work out, we'll get married sooner. Sorry we had to hold it off so much for this. It's a year of a pay cut. Me not living with you.
Mm. You got a house now.
Yeah.
One, just one.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good times that made us laugh outweigh the bad. I thought we'd get forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. I don't know where this road is going to be. All I know is where we've been and what we've been through. If we get to see tomorrow, I hope it's worth all the wait. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Troy, your incredible personality and knack for creativity resonate with yo-yoers across the world. You believed in me and allowed me to represent your amazing dream. Thank you so much.
I really wish I didn't have to say this. Goodbye, Troy. Miss you, brother.
I know I didn't know you too well, and the time we spent was short, but you really left an impression on my life, and we're gonna miss you. Rest in peace, Troy, and yo-yo it up in the heavens, my friend.
Troy, I miss you way too much, buddy. I'm sure wherever you are, you're in a better place now. Just know that you're gone, but you'll never be forgotten.
It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
And I also want people to continue to enjoy it. Because without that, the company would be no more. And that would suck.